Hello dear students, in today's class I teach you the next topic named switch statement available in C language. This topic is really very important as examination point of view. Definitely you find question on switch in an examination. Till today I taught you what are conditional statements. Conditional statements are used by C programmers to take certain decisions based on certain conditions. That is, sometimes for us necessary to execute or skip certain block of statements based on certain condition, and is possible by conditional statements supported by C language. Already we know about simple if. Simple if was one way decision making statement. We don't have any more choices. If the condition is true, then only it follows true block, otherwise no. If else, two way decision making statement. We have here two choices, either the first works or the second works based on given condition. That's why we called it as two way decision making statement. Nested if. Within if we use another if or another if else. That is what we called nested if. That is one of the multi-way decision making statement available in C language. We select one of the many. In the last class I taught you else if ladder. Else if ladder is also called as cascaded if, to select one of the many. In today's class I teach you switch. Switch is also multi-way decision making statement available in C language. But the problems whichever we can solve by using nested if, else if ladder and switch are different. Mainly the switch is used by programmers to develop those programs in which the programmer wants to provide menu options for its users. In our everyday routine life we come across n number of menu options while working with the applications. For example, while working with our smartphone also we found many menus. According to selected option, that option is going to work. Look at this simple example. Now we need to develop a software. Whenever we run that software, we get this menu on the screen or the monitor or on the terminal. One is for area of circle, two is for to find area of rectangle, one is for area of circle, two for area of rectangle, three for area of triangle. Enter your choice. Being a user of this program, if I enter my choice as 1, then the program will ask me to enter the radius of circle, then it shows the area of circle. Instead of 1 choice, if I enter 2, then that program will ask me to enter the length and breadth of rectangle. Accordingly, I get the result. Instead of 2, if I enter 3 as my choice, I get it will ask me to enter breadth and height of a triangle or 3 sides of a triangle. Accordingly, I get the result. If I enter other than 1 or 2 or 3, I get appropriate invalid message like invalid choice or the input. Now you need to develop such software or the programs so that you can provide menu options to its users. That is possible by making the use of switch statement. That's why switch is mainly used by C programmers to provide menu options. Here also one of the many works. That's why switch is called as multi-way decision making or condition statement available in C language. Now I start my today's class. Then how to explain about the switch in the examination? It is another multi-way statement available in C language. It helps the programmers to select one from many alternatives. It is mainly used by us or the programmers to provide menu options for the end users of a program so that they can select one from many displayed menu options. Then how to make the use of it? See the syntax. But before studying the syntax, look at the example so that you can understand the syntax so easily. See this simple program as an example. On the machine, on the terminal, I get this message, enter your choice. You can enter the choice as either 1 or 2 or 3. Whatever the choice we enter, that will be stored in CH. That one we pass to the switch. Assume that choice selected by me was 1. 1 we are passing. Whether this 1 matches with the first value, if the passed value and the given case value, if both are same or if both are matches, then machine follows this instruction. You have selected first choice, then the break takes place. That means we exit from the switch. Assume that passed value is not 1. Entered choice is 2. Entered choice is 2 means CH is having the number 2. That 2 we are passing. Whether 2 matches with 1? No. Whether 2 matches with 2? Yes. That means this printf works. You have selected second choice. Again we exit from the switch. If you enter your choice as 3, first again we are passing the value 3 here. Whether 3 matches with 1? No. Whether 3 matches with 2? No. Whether 3 matches with 3? Yes. That means we get this message on the terminal. You have selected third choice. As usual, again break takes place. If you enter other than 1 or 2 or 3, there will be no match with 1, there will be no match with 2, there will be no match with 3. That means default works, invalid choice. Slash A means A stands for alarm. Even we get the beep also from the CPU's speaker. As usual, break takes place. Here my switch started, here my switch completes. In this switch, switch is also a keyword, case is also a keyword, default is also a keyword. And here colon has been used, and here you can use multiple instructions also. All these statements ends with semicolon, and once again semicolon will not come for the switch also. This is what the very simple example for the switch. In order to write this program, we need to define one integer variable. What is that? CH. And we read the choice we pass, accordingly the program works. This is what the simple program. See the output also I have written in my notes. Enter your choice 1 or 2 or 3. If you enter as 2, you have selected second choice. If you enter as 5, invalid choice. This is what the simple program. Then in order to write this program, I followed some rules. Switch is must, one value we pass, case is must, value to be compared, some statements, break, case is must, value to, colon is must, some statements, break, case is must, some value, some statements, break is must, default, some statements, break. This is optional, then end. This is what we call syntax. That syntax we can see here. Switch is must, we pass one value. The passed value will be compared with the value 1. If these two are same, then the first block works, then the break takes place. If there is no match found between these two, then machine will compare it for value 2. If these two are same, then machine follows these instruction, again break takes place. If there is no match with 1 and 2, then the machine will check for the third value. If these two are same, then machine follows, again break takes place. Like this you can check n number of conditions. These number of cases depends on the software or the program whichever you are going to develop. Then the default statements will be there. If there is no match found, then the machine follows these instructions. As usual, break takes place. Using break here is optional. You may use or you may not. Statement X means not related to the switch, every time works. This is what the syntax. Don't forget to write the syntax in the examination. Then in examination, you can explain the syntax also in your own words. In the above syntax, the passed value will be compared against all the case values one after another from top to bottom. Wherever it matches, the associated block of statements will be executed by the machine, otherwise it executes default block of statements. Like this you can explain the things in your own way. This is what all about the syntax of switch. But in examination they ask you to draw the flowchart of switch also. That one I will show you now. Here you can see the flowchart of switch. In exam you get a question on explain the switch statement with its syntax and the flowchart. This flowchart you need to draw in examination. Switch starts here. Means to the body of switch we pass one value. That value will be compared against the first case. Whether the passed value and the case one matches, that means first block of statement is going to work. then the break of the switch takes place. Assume that the past value is not matching with the one. Here you need to write true. Yes means true. Here you need to write false. If there is no match, then second value will be checked by machine. If these two matches, then this works. Again the break takes place. No match with 1 and 2, then the third will be matched. This is not the case number 3. Case number 3 is the default one. If there is no match with 1 and 2, then the default statement works. This is what the flowchart of switch. You can draw this flowchart with freehand sketch in examination. You'll be having less time in examination. That's why you can draw this flowchart by your own. This flowchart carries 1 marks for you. Just practice on rough papers and write in examination. This is what all about how to draw the flowchart of switch. Now in exam, first you have to explain switch, then write the syntax, afterwards draw the flowchart, then explain the syntax and give one programming example like this in examination. If you give the example like this, you get very good marks in exam. Now we need to know the limitations of using switch also. In interview, they ask sometime, what are the limitations of using switch statement? We can pass only integer value to the body of switch. Means the value whichever we use for comparison, that must be integer. But in this part, you can use the character type, float type, any type of value you can use. But the value whichever we pass to the body of switch for comparison, that must be integer. Only for the comparison. Even you can pass character also. Character is also an integer for machine. That means the value whichever we use for comparison, that must be integer or character constant, only for comparison. But inside the body of switch you can use any type of value. That is the limitation of using switch. Rules for using switch statement. The switch value must be an integer type, means the value whichever we pass, that must be integer or character. Case labels must be unique. We cannot repeat the case values to be compared. Next, case labels must end with semicolon. Yes, case labels must end with semicolon. Break and default are optional. You may use or you may not. If you won't use break, execution flows down. That's why better use the break. This default part you can write anywhere in the switch body. Whenever there will be no match, then only works. Using default part is also optional. You may use or you may not. If you use it, you can use it anywhere. Then also it works. I think you understood. In exam, if you get a question on switch, explain the switch, write the syntax, draw the flowchart, write the limitation, write the rules, give one simple example like this, then you may get 10 or 12 marks in examination. I come up with the next video with some more examples on switch. Thank you. Have a nice day. Take care.